This is going to be called the crochet chat that ended in curtains. Tribe, so it's Thursday the 22nd of August and it's in the evening. I am propped up in my little corner. I have got everything that I need to be comfy. My fairy lights are on. I've got my Mac, my dinner is cooking, and there's enough there for my food tomorrow. My gym bag's packed, I'm ready to roll, so I am just going to enjoy some of my time crocheting. I'm working on another project, another granny square project, as always, and I have been making the centres for my granny squares, and I've got them here. And I'm picking yarn out of this bag. It's my resting knit face bag from Stephen and Penelope, and I got it when I was at Edinburgh Yarn Festival. And in here I've got all of this yarn and all my yarn bath, and these are the colours that I've picked out for yet another granny square project that none of you know about, but this image of this project just came to me and I just thought, why haven't I done this already? Like, why? So I've started it. There's balls of yarn everywhere. This is my happy place. I have my crochet blanket on me. This is Granddad's blanket. I've got all my books here. I'm comfy. I've got Harry Potter on. Like, I'm wearing something Harry Potter. I've got my comfy shorts on. My Mac's here. I'm watching Tiny House Nation series 1. I'm on episode 3. It's almost finished. I'm mad, absolutely mad for the tiny house world. So I feel like I've just given you a lot of information there. But surrounded by my books, in my cozy corner, like, how cute is this nook? It's a bit annoying, you can see that label. Damn. I'm watching Tiny House Nation, which is people that decide to downsize their living space so they can upgrade their life. The idea being the smaller space costs less money to then buy and make, less money to run, like utility costs, and there's less space, so you've got less stuff in there, which means that you own less, so you're spending less, and that also, because you have less stuff, you spend less time tidying up, cleaning, like, who knows that struggle. And I'm just obsessed with it. As much as I'm obsessed with van life, I'm obsessed with tiny living and minimalism and simplifying your life. So I'm watching that as well, and I'm making the centres in my happy spot, as I said. So that was a long-winded way to say, after a long, long day and a long, long week and a long, long couple of months, and I'm not even exaggerating, Patreons, you know how long it's been, I'm working on this divine little project and I'm so excited for you to see it, but I'm not going to tell you what it is right now. I'm just going to keep working on it and then show you the finish. Ta-da! I'm also working on, and I'm not going to get up right now and grab them, I'll grab them in a minute, the squares for Stella Take 2. Stella is out of shop just behind you, and Stella Take 2 is on the floor. I've paused on that because I'm going to do a tutorial, hopefully, of me doing the continuous join as you go, and I wanted to take pictures of the next steps for my pattern when I release it. And then also I bought magnetic clasps. So I bought one for Stella 1 and it's in a heart shape and it was cute, but it's a little bit small and it's not that strong. So I've gone for a bigger size. It's a circle and it's 18mm, whereas Stella 1 had a 14mm, and I just took one out of the bag and it was like clunk. So yeah, I'm pleased with that. And I brought 10 of them for the price of that one heart. So that's a no-brainer, that's pretty cool. This project is gonna have a zipper. It's gonna be lined in the same material that I've also brought to line Stella 2. And this is gonna be very similar color scheme to Stella 1. However, this project, I'm gonna put a little bit of yellow in there. Then all of the second rounds of the squares is going to be in this amazing rose blush glitter from the pound shop. And then the join is going to be in something like this, maybe not this one because I feel that this is a little bit thinner than a standard DK and it's just from my stash, but I want it to be a light color like this. I really want to buy some more light coloured yarn, but I promised myself I wouldn't buy any more yarn until I made money from my patterns or more money on my Patreon. So I need to get the pattern out there. If anybody wants to sign up to my Patreon or make a donation on this, I can go get some more light coloured yarn and finish this amazing project. Please, please do that, and I will just... Without a doubt, you'll be getting a shout out because I'll be like, shout out to X, Y, and Z. You're the most amazing person ever and I got this yarn. But for now, I'm going to hold fire and just trust that that yarn's going to come into my life somehow. So I'm going to stop rabbiting on because this was just going to be a hey, this is the date. And then I was just going to do some time lapse of me crocheting whilst I watch my tiny house nation. So... I'm going to stop yabbering on. I'm going to crochet because I've waited all day for this. All day. One thing I've done with this project though, which I get really annoyed at myself when I do, is I haven't worked out how many squares I need. I just jumped in, like I saw the project in my head and I've gone against all my own rules. I quickly like measured out, I set out some squares just to see how many I'd need down and across. So I've got a rough idea because this project's gonna be 4 by 5. Wait, that's about the size of Stella. 4 by 5, it's like one of Stella's panels pretty much. So at least 20 squares. I've got 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I can do another 10 centres and then do this the second round. But I think actually, out of this first 10, I'm going to put the second round on. I like doing them in batches because I feel what it is more time effective. And I'm really trying to be as productive as possible, so when I'm working on a project I have not limited, but I don't always have as much time as I would like to work on a project, and so I'm just trying to make it as productive as possible when I do sit down. And I've found that doing all of my centers at once, like in one go, is more time effective because I can sit here, pick out the yarn from out of the bag, and then do the center, and then I drop that yarn beside me here or make a second pile, and I keep picking out of the bag and that way I'm not then sort of looking or double guessing, like, have I used that colour, have I not? I know, because if it's in the bag then I've not used it. But because I've just done 10 of them, I don't mind having repeats. There's 20 squares, so I'd happily have repeats. I could pick the same colours again if I wanted to. But there's enough still in the bag that it doesn't even matter. And my plan is, because it takes me 2 minutes to make these squares, I will probably sit here tomorrow evening, my Friday night, yes, and do the next 10 centres, and then I can pack all of this yarn away. One thing that I have been doing though is every night before I go to bed, I have been, if I'm sitting down here and I'm working on a project, I tidy up and I do like what I say, I call it resetting to factory settings. So I put everything back as if I just tidied the room up. Like, you know, every weekend you tidy up and you make it all look nice. So that I can leave the room, I make it look like that, only there will be like piles of yarn. So I'll have to turn you round in a minute because Stella 2 is on the floor down there. But I do that just so that when I walk in a room, I don't feel overwhelmed. I just really like it being tidy. I really like it looking nice and neat. And I make my bed every day as well, because my day goes so much more like smoothly. Does anyone else do that? And I just really like to, after a long day, to walk into my room and my bed just look inviting, rather than I've got to tidy up all of yesterday's mess before I can deal with today's mess. The only time I don't 100% stick to that rule is when there's dishes in the sink. I don't. I'm working on it though. So I will tidy up tonight, but I will just leave this pile of yarn that's down here, I'll just tidy it up into a tidy pile next to the bag, ready to pick up from again tomorrow. I have that luxury, I guess, in that I live alone. I don't have kids or anyone that's going to move my piles. So, yeah, I guess if I was sharing a house or living with someone, like, I kind of feel a little bit sorry for my future partner, because he's like, well, I feel sorry for him because he already finds little bits of yarn everywhere I go. Like, the first time I met him, I went to the bathroom and then I came back and he went to the bathroom a little bit later and he walked in like, what's this? And I was like, yarn, ends of yarn. And he was like, how did it get in the bathroom? I was like, I don't know, it just follows me everywhere and it falls out. I don't know how it got in there. I didn't take yarn in with me. Like, I have no clue. So that happens already when I'm visiting. So imagine what it's going to be like living with me. But I imagine that he will get used to my random piles of yarn, because that's what makes me me. Anyway, am I rambling? I feel like maybe I'm rambling. So on my second round, I finished the square. Look how cute they are. Oh. Oh. They're so cute. I finished the second round because I'm going to sew all the ends in before I do the join as you go method on this. But because these are so cute, I'm not gonna lie, Tribe, like, I'm loving the tiny granny squares. Oh. And yes, I know they're double, but this colour was in there twice. Oh, they're so cute. I'm thinking of doing a project with just two round granny squares. And then I think, are you crazy? That's gonna take you ages. But then I'm like, but they're so cute. So cute. Yeah, I'm not 100% sure. Okay, I've just got this image in my head that I want to make a blanket out of two square granny squares. That's crazy, isn't it? But I can see it in my head and it looks great, and it's going to be a long-term project, i.e. it's never going to get finished because you're crazy. But then also there's a few like outfits that I want to make with the two round grannies. Oh gosh, I don't know. And then in my head I was like, oh, that's my food. Let me just tell you this. In my head I was like, well, I could just use chunky yarn and do the two round grannies, because that would still be cute, but then they won't be as small, so then it won't be cute. So I think I'm going to commit to a two round granny square project. Whether that be a blanket or a garment. I also just remembered that I was going to make something else for my bedroom and I didn't. I'm going to grab my I'm going to grab my journal and sit and write some of these out, and also work out the exact measurements for this project. I love it already. I love it already. Isn't it so like bizarre almost how changing the centers changes the granny completely? Anyway, oh, and that stack, it almost looks edible. Right, I'm gonna do one more whilst chatting to you. Then I'm going to eat my food, and then, I don't know what the time is. Oh, it's only 9:45. It's a lot earlier than I thought. Then after eating, I'm going to time-lapse me working on this project. Though I'm in a really chatty mood, so I might just come back and chat a bit more, why not? And then I'm going to upload this as just some rambling title. This could actually be an entire vlog actually, because I've just hit 17 minutes, which is crazy. There's just something so bliss about this little spot, and I wanted to share it with you. You can see my beautiful books behind me, you can see my fairy lights, got a bit of crochet. I just love this spot and I love being surrounded by the things that are so important to me. Like, don't get me wrong, belongings aren't everything, and in the grand scheme of things they're not hugely important, but the belongings that I have are functional and they bring me joy, and that's what's important. Somebody did comment before about my bookshelves, and I was tempted to give you a bookshelf tour, but I don't know if anyone would be interested in that, so let me know, because mine are all set out in a really cute way. So they're organised by colour coordinated. So you can see behind me the white shelf, then there's the black shelf, and then there's a colourful one. And then below the colourful one is all my DVDs. But then above this white one is another black shelf, and then the one above is all my Harry Potters. And then a lot of my self-development books are on my windowsill. And then over in the corner I've got another unit with more books on. The entire bottom shelf is black and the one above are all different colours. Four squares. I don't know if I'm going to be able to hold them all up, but so cute. Right, I've got to rescue my dinner because I'm going to have overboiled potatoes. Oh, so cute, so cute, so cute. And then when I come back, I will probably just chat to you some more, to be honest. I'm in a chatty mood. So I'm going to get my food and then I'll be right back. I'm back, tribe. I'm back, ek. I'm back, ek. You can see there's a stalk growing of granny squares. I've got two left to put the outer edge on. I had my food and I've just put the edging on like three of them maybe. And I was watching a bit more of Tiny House Nation. I'm just loving it. If there are any other similar sorts of series that you know of, then let me know, because I need them in my life. And if there's any like small space tiny living on YouTube that you'd like to watch, also let me know. And then whatever, if you don't know of any of those but you've got a good recommendation on YouTube, then holler at me, because whilst making granny squares I get a lot of watching done. I like to set myself challenges and be like, right, at the end of this episode I will have all of my ends sewn in. Go, go, go. So this will be the 10th second round that I've done this evening, and I'm going to pick out another 10 to start the second batch of first rounds. I also need to go and pick some yellow out to add in, so I might do that sooner rather than later, like now. Yeah. Oops. I'm really, really excited for you to see this project, but sorry guys, but only the Patreons are seeing it this weekend. I'm gonna keep it quiet for the rest of you. So I guess you have to go check out Patreon or hit subscribe so you can see next time. And next time will be... I'm doing pretty well at the moment, like I don't want to jinx myself, but I am getting videos out every weekend, well every week. At the moment they tend to be coming out sort of really late Sunday or early Monday. I'm working on it so that you're getting them actually in the weekend, because I get most of my time to watch vlogs at the weekend, and I imagine most people do. It's just that I record at the weekend and then by the time I've done all the editing and got it uploaded, it's not the weekend anymore. Oh my goodness, I just love them. Stack of very pink granny squares. So I've got a lilac centre, Barbie pink, let's stack these up, purple, I don't know what shade I would call that purple, another Barbie pink, whoops, baby pink, that's really catching the light and blurring out. Glitter white. Let me come this way. Baby grey. I'm in the most awkward position. And then there's a pinky coral. Another baby pink. Another peachy coral. So that was like pinky coral, and that's peachy coral. Then a darker grey, slate grey. And then a pop of pink. More neon pink. Is there 10? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I think there were 10 when I've got 12. So I only need 8 more. They're so cute, you can't quite see them. Oh, so cute! Have some juice. I drink my fruit juice in a Prosecco glass. I just always have them. Makes me feel extra special. Right. You see, this is why I do all the centres at the same time, because now I'm going to be double, triple checking that I don't have too many repeats of the same one. But it's okay. I'm going in with this colour, which is unravelling itself. I'm going to have quite a bit of the continuous. Join as you go to record and take pictures of. That's okay. So yeah, other things I was going to tell you about are lining my Stella 2. I've ordered like a dusky pink polyester satin. I just bought a meter off it from eBay, but I bought it from the UK. It's coming from Birmingham, which is like 40 miles from here. And I, excuse me while I count, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I have bought a meter. I definitely won't need a meter to do Stella 2, but they didn't. I could have bought a half meter, I think, and I didn't. I bought a meter, but in my head I've got other projects that I'm going to make with it, so that's okay. And I'm going to line this project with it. Look at that yarn bath. Oh goodness me. And my plan is to use it all up, so even if there's quite a bit left, I will just keep, I'll just keep using it basically. I have got ideas in my head of some of the gifts that I want to make for Christmas this year, and so with that in mind, I know that I can use that pink up. I don't think I'll have much left over, but I'm really adamant that whatever I get, I will be using up. I don't want a huge stash anymore. I did buy 10 magnetic purse clasps, so, but they cost the price of the one I bought for Stella, as I said, the heart-shaped. So that gives you an indication of how many of these projects I plan on making. I didn't think that they would arrive as quickly as they have, so now I just get my fabric. Hopefully I get the fabric by the end of the weekend, and then, because it's bank holiday, in the UK. It's the last bank holiday of the year before Christmas. Monday, I'm hoping to get a lot of recording done. I'm hoping to get the lining of Stella recorded and the continuous join as you go recorded and both photographed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. I knew there was too many. So hopefully that arrives for Monday. So either tomorrow or Saturday it needs to arrive really. But I've got the 10 clasps. I can't say clasp very well, can I? And I intend to make a few purses for Christmas presents. So I went to see my friend today. Her name's Emily, and we went to uni together, and I've got the most amazing idea in my head for a project, for another like purse for her. That's a bit bright. I'm doing it. Yeah, I've got a purse in mind that I want to make her. So that will be, so if I do Stella 2, and I've got 10 clasps to use up, Stella 2, Emily's purse, then I've got another granny square purse in mind that I want to make. It's going to be like a fold over big clutch that will also have a zipper for going in. I want to make need some ideas, tribe, because that's another 7 magnetic clasps that I want to use up. I've got more ideas in my head though, I'm sure of it, they're just not coming to me because pressure. I wanted to make a laptop cozy as well for my Mac, but that won't have a magnetic stud, that's more likely to be a zipper. And I'd line that one in fleece to give it that extra, not fleece, maybe fleece or felt I was thinking actually, to give it that extra padded protection. But no, that would be a zipper. And then I'd like to make, I've got a couple of bag ideas in mind. But I feel like they need a slightly different yarn, like they need t-shirt yarn or nylon yarn, so but I'll get there. And I'm sure, like as I said, I want to make Emily's purse, fine, but then I also want to make and Emily's purse will be a variation of Stella basically. Well, it will be Stella, and I know exactly what material I want to line it with. And the colours that I would make it out of. But then the envelope clutch bag that I'm on about, like the overfold one, which you're going to have no idea what I'm going on about, I will make that, and then I'll make a second one which I will then use to make the pattern like I have done for Stella. So that'll be 2 used up. So then I've got 6 clasps to use. And I can tell you of maybe 2 other projects in mind. So then if I do 2 of them, that's 4. So then that leaves 2. So I think I can use them up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. But anyway, they're not huge, so they won't take up a lot of room and they won't be in the stash long, so that's great. The lining will be gone pretty quick. I've got an idea for a 2 round granny square project in my mind. And if it's not a blanket, I want it to be a curtain for my room. A curtain made out of 2 round. Really? I really want to. I really, really want to. Oh, goodness me. I think I'm going to have to do it, tribe. Just imagine. Work with me here. Oh. Really? Really? 2 rounds. Really, I want to do it. Uh-oh. This is going to be called the crochet chat that ended in curtains. Imagine all these 2 round squares like this in this cute, amazing pink. See, I've got another variation in my head though where there's some of the outer edges are just a random colour, just an odd colour here and there. But that would look so cute. And then I could back it with a blackout material or just... Would I back it with blackout? Because then you would lose the granny effect when it's hanging up. I don't mind that the light's not blacked out in my room, but I know that it bugs other people. And I wouldn't want somebody to not sleep round just because it doesn't block the light out. It's my room though. Or I could just back it with a nice... You know the material that I was going to... That I was umming and ahhing about lining my big granny square bag with, something like that on the back of that. What am I doing? That's what I want to do. I want to make a 2 round granny square curtain for my bedroom. Just one big panel that doesn't come below the windowsill really, just sort of sits level with the windowsill, and I can put a trim on it. I'll make tab tops for it to go up. I'm doing it. I'm making a granny square. I'm making a granny square curtain, tribe. See, I knew that I needed to sit down and talk to you today, and this is why. And what I think I'll do, I'll measure the window, and I'll write that down, and then I'll work out, and then measure one of these. And I'll work out how many squares that equates to. And then I'm going to sit and make a giant bag of granny squares. Do I want 2 rounds or 3 rounds? I'm going to make a giant bag of all these centres, of however many I need. And then if I go with 2 rounds, I can sit and do continuous join as you go. Which means that I won't have to snip this, I'll just keep going. If I want to do 3 rounds, which I'm umming and ahhing about, purely because it makes it a bit bigger. Help me, tribe. Help me. Do I want 2 rounds or do I want 3 rounds? Or my brain has just said, well, there's 2 windows upstairs that need curtains. The hallway needs one as well. I could do those in 3 rounds and black that, and then back that with blackouts that nobody can see in my room. My bedroom I'm not as bothered about because it's not really overlooked, and it's also got a blackout blind which I could put down. Oh my goodness. I'm making 2 granny square curtains. I'm gonna make a big bag of all these centers. The one in my bedroom, I've got 2 ideas for curtains, 2 curtains. One of them is going to be 2 round squares all edged in this pink, and all the centres will be different colours. The second curtain idea is going to be 3 rounds, all the centres are going to be different, and then the outer edges are going to be a lot of different neutrals and pinks. And then one of them is going to be backed in black back out, and one is might not even get backed. So do I want my bedroom to look more, to be the more neutral? Yeah, I think I do. Oh my goodness. So excited for this project. What am I doing to myself? So my bedroom's just gonna be all the pink ones. Two round squares. And the hallway, I'm gonna do three rounds. And then I'm gonna pick out the colours. So you can't actually see it, but the back of my bookcase is actually painted in the colour that's in the hallway. And so I want it to be complementary colours to that. I'm so excited. Oh my goodness, I'm so excited. So I've committed to two. There's one more that I might do. And that's my door. My front door also needs a curtain. And the funny thing is, I say I'm gonna line them. I've got the old lining from the curtains that used to be up there, but they're red and they don't go with the decoration. So I've tucked them down so I could take that lining off and use the granny squares. But I'm not going to commit to a door curtain because that's even more work. But there's the potential to do that as well. I want to make a curtain for my bedroom out of two round granny squares. Hi, my name's Heather of HG Designs Crochet, and I want to make a granny square curtain out of two round granny squares. I'm doing it, tribe. Wow. Okay, so this one I can tell is already going to be longer than I intended. I'm going to make this into an entire vlog and put it up. It's just going to be a crochet chat that ended in curtains. Oh my goodness, the crochet chat that ended in curtains. Ah, what am I doing? Two curtains. I'm going to put a little bit of time lapse vloggy footage in of me making some more centers. I'm really excited. Can't wait to raid my stash. Ooh! Okay, right. I've got to get out of my head because I'm just thinking and I'm imagining it up. I'm going to end this one here. I didn't record a proper intro for you either, so if you've got this far, thank you for watching HGDC, HG Designs Crochet. I've enjoyed our little crochet chat today, and out of it I've decided I'm making curtains. This project, funny enough, you're not going to see until maybe the week after, but it is on Patreon for you. So sign up to my Patreon. Whoever signs up to my Patreon is funding my yarn. I do love yarn dearly. And I've also got Stella 2 on the go, which I haven't even shown you. So please, please, please subscribe and come back next week for more of a regular vlog, because you will see Stella 2, this project, which I will finally show you and name. Hopefully it'll be finished, and then you should see the start of my crochet curtain. So wow. And you know what, that's also perfect because I'm going on a spa retreat, and I wanted a project to take with me. And the thing with all the granny squares and all the different colours is that you have to take a lot of yarn, but I could take 10 colours and make 8 centres of each, and then they'll be ready to put my second round on. So I just feel like that's already falling into place. I'm a little bit like, as a good way to finish a day that started out feeling long-winded and has ended in so many amazing things. I had a really good catch-up with my friend, and I've got so many great things like being planned, and I'm just so excited right now. So excited I've committed to two crochet curtains. So I'm going to leave it here. Just put a little bit of vloggy footage of me making some centres as well. I've been trying to say goodbye for like 5 minutes and my brain's just like, curtains! Wow. And also, when I started recording I saw a spider. So now, I don't go over that part of the room. And it was on the curtain, so I can't open the curtain now, so I'm just going to leave that shut for weeks. I'm not even joking, weeks. So thank you so much for watching. I did ask you to put comments below for Netflix recommendations or YouTube channels. And make sure that you tell everybody about my channel. Like, I'm getting so close to 1,000 subscribers now. Every day subscribers go up. So thank you to all my day one subscribers, and thank you to all the brand new ones that are here and have found me. Please make sure you tell somebody else to come along and join the tribe. And I will see you again soon with Stella, with my, I almost told you what it was then, secret project and the start of my curtains. So for that, I feel like that is a good place to end and say I'm calling curtains, and I will see you again soon. Wherever you are, if you're in the UK, have a great bank holiday weekend. And if you are in the rest of the world, and I hope you have a wonderful weekend and you enjoy making moments and memories. Okay tribe, it's getting real late and I've already said night to you, and then I sat here watching Tiny Nation making centers for my squares for my curtain. I feel like when I did this, that's a good like end credit, like, curtain. Oh my goodness, I'm going to sleep because it's 11:15. Oh no, my alarm goes off at 6 a.m. But I've just done 21 centres. I don't know how many I need, but there's 21. I've started on my third colour, you can see. Okay, tribe. Okay. That is me out. I have 3 projects on the go. Actually, I've got 1, 2, 3 granny square projects. That's what I was sticking to. I've got 3 granny square projects on the go.